Now let's answer some questions about comparisons. The first is, what is the difference between the Intuos Pen, Pen and Touch, and Manga models? Besides the difference in bundled software, the Intuos Pen Small has a smaller drawing surface, 6 by 3.7 inches, no eraser on the pen, and no touch feature. The Intuos Pen and Touch Small and Medium are the same as the Intuos Pen, but with touch capability and an eraser on the pen. The Intuos Manga is the same as the Intuos Pen and Touch, but with different bundled software for manga artists. If you want to know more about the features and specifications of each of these tablets and how they compare to each other, visit Wacom's website and compare all of the models together. You can get all of your answers there. The next question is, should I choose the small or the medium size? All sizes of tablets will work fine for all software applications. If you have a small desk, a small laptop screen, or limited space, you should consider a small tablet. Smaller tablets are fine for handwriting and photo editing, but if you'll be painting and drawing often, a medium tablet is better because you'll have more room to move your hand around. Another frequently asked question is, should I choose the Intuos or the Intuos Pro? If you're doing mostly photo editing or you're a beginner, the Intuos will be more than adequate for your needs. However, if you're going to be drawing often or creating art professionally, you'll benefit from the additional features and larger drawing area of the Intuos Pro. The next question is, should I buy an older model like the Bamboo or the Intuos 5? If you're trying to save money or you're a beginner, then yes, an older model might be good for you. However, in my opinion, the modern Intuos would be a better option because it comes with newer bundled software and drivers. Now, on the topic of maintenance, a common question is, how do I replace the pen nibs? What you want to do on this particular model is use the nib grabber to pull the nib out. It's a little metal ring that came with your pen. It's probably somewhere in your box if you take a look around for it. You can watch this video for a walkthrough on how to change the pen nibs. Now here's a good question. Why can't I find my replacement nibs? The replacement nibs on the Intuos are located inside a small panel that slides out on the back of the tablet. Another common question is, how often will I need to replace the nibs? The answer for that is not very often. It depends on how often you draw and how much friction you use while you're drawing. I go through one or two nibs a year and I draw every day, so that gives you an idea of how infrequently I have to change my nibs. Some people claim to go through nibs more rapidly, but it might be because they're not using very good techniques while they're drawing. So here's some tips to avoid unnecessary nib wear. You can try using the eraser to erase rather than the pen tip. Use the pen only for drawing and not for everyday navigation. And change the pressure sensitivity in the Wacom tablet properties so that you don't have to press so hard to vary your pressure. So that's it for the Wacom Intuos Frequently Asked Questions. If you still don't have an answer to your question, please contact Wacom for tech support. If you found this information helpful, take a quick second to like this video and share it with your friends on YouTube and on Facebook. And don't forget to click the subscribe button to see my latest videos as they're released. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.